Did you receive one of these in the mail? Well, if so, you have a damn big mailbox. And I'm here to show you how to use the one and only glorious Dyna-Glow Vertical Offset Smoker.
But first, how about some good news, bad news, good news? The good news is this thing is big enough to smoke 3 briskets and more. The bad news, it says right in the box, it's just a charcoal smoker. But the good news is I'm going to show you how I use it as a wood smoker, and we're going to cover a whole lot more. So stay tuned to Chuck Wagon for the ultimate Dyna-Glow wide body vertical offset smoker tutorial. Yay! Let's get rolling.
Before we dive in, let's take a look at the box and the manual. The box will weigh around 105 pounds, so you're going to need another person or a dolly to move it. It's 39 inches long, 17 inches wide, and 26 inches deep. The instruction manual is in English, Spanish, and French. Let's take a look. There's a table of contents, of course. I've circled in red the things you actually have to install, such as the legs, the handles, the smoke vent, the latches, temp gauge, and the firebox. It comes with the bolts and nuts you will need, but you will need a Phillips head screwdriver and a wrench, or channel locks or nut driver. Putting it together is a fairly simple process. The instructions go step by step and are easy to follow. It took me about an hour and I did most of the work myself. Once you get everything together, the rest of the parts plug in or slide in. There are operating and care instructions, as well as handy tips for wood and temperature guidelines. And of course, your warranty information, and then the rest of the manual is in the other languages. All right, let's take a look around Dyna and see what she's all about. Notice the cover. That's essential, and we'll get into that later. Ta-da! One of the first things you'll notice is the temperature gauge. It's accurate, but limited. I'll cover that a bit later as well. There are two handles on either end, which makes moving Dyna from place to place simple, but a bit awkward. There's a vent in the center of the cabinet, which doesn't quite open or close all the way. It's kind of weird. There's a vent on the firebox cabinet, and that one does open and close all the way. All right, let's take some measures. She stands just 9.5 inches above the ground. The smoker cabinet is 35 inches tall by 24 inches wide. The firebox cabinet is 14 inches tall by 12.5 inches wide. The total height from the ground is almost 45 inches. And the depth of the smoker is 14 inches, 15 including the door. Let's move on to what you can expect inside the wide body. I forgot to mention the latches. There's one on the side and one on the bottom. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. They say beauty's on the inside. I tend to agree. Up top, there are pre-installed hooks for sausage. I tried to hang trout one time and it didn't work out so well. There is also a very nice removable rib rack. There are six.
Six.
Yes, six racks, and these racks are adjustable. You simply have to move the rack sliders to the height you need. It's pretty simple. With all six racks inside and equally spaced, you get about 3 inches apart. Each rack has a depth of 13.5 inches and a width of 22 inches, which gives you nearly 300 square inches for each rack. The firebox has three removable parts. the charcoal and wood chamber, the chamber grate, and the ashtray. The length of the basket is just a bit over 11 inches. The width is about 8.5 inches. And the depth is about 5.5 inches. And of course, there's a grease trap with a removable grease tray. Let's get into a few things I think you need to do for Dinah right off the bat, and links will be provided. The first thing is get a cover. If you only buy one accessory for Dinah, this is it. It's vital for keeping your smoker nice and dry and free from rust. This one was less than $30 and is made just for the wide body. Now this one is optional. You'll notice that I lifted Dinah up a bit with some garden stones. It's just a tad too low, for me anyway. This gave it a more manageable working height. Another important thing to do is level and plumb Dinah. This is important for a lot of reasons, such as the swing of your doors and not having food or grease roll where they're not wanted. Just like with your favorite wok or cast iron skillet, seasoning is essential to building a patina to protect the steel of your smoker. And you're going to want to do this before you start cooking anything. I actually seasoned mine about 3 times before I smoked anything, and I continue to do it about every 6 months now. And she's held up pretty good for these past 3 years. To do so is simple. Remove everything from the inside, then spray or wipe it down with a thin layer of vegetable oil, making sure to cover it completely. Now, it doesn't call for using oil in the manual, but it's a pretty standard way to season an offset smoker. Also do the outside. The steel of Dinah is pretty thin and needs all the protection it can get. To complete the seasoning, you simply build a fire as you normally would with no food. And when cool, wipe off any excess with a clean towel. I'm going to complete this process a bit later in the tutorial. Next, you're going to want to seal up your joints and seams with a high-temp waterproof silicone sealant. When you season, you'll notice smoke leaking from various seams. The sealant will help button that up. You're going to want to go completely around the firebox, along the top of the smoker, and also along the bottom. And finally, a gasket. This is a high-temp gasket, 1/2 inch by 1/4 inch. With one side having a sticky adhesive. It fits perfectly in the gap of the smoker cabinet door, sealing it up nicely. You'll want to go completely around the whole door. And I'll leave a link to this and everything else I used in the description. So, you've taken your first steps and you're ready to smoke your brisket. But hold up, because Dinah has a slight size problem.
Houston, we have a little problem.
And the problem is, Dinah's firebox is too small, and most logs are too big. It's not her fault, it's just the way she was made. You see, to use Dinah as a hardwood smoker, you're going to want to use split logs from a dealer like this. It's just the most economical way to smoke. And these splits are going to be at least 12 inches long. Now, I suppose you could size down to chunks, but in my opinion, these are way too small for just smoking with wood. Let me demonstrate. I'm going to pull out the firebox basket and show you what's going on. If you use the splits as is, it's going to stick outside, where a good portion will be wasted burning outside the firebox. There will be too much air and it will burn too hot. Now, if you use just wood chunks, you're going to go through a lot of bags to smoke a brisket. Yes, you could also use charcoal, and Dinah is sold as a charcoal smoker, but that's not what I'm trying to do here. I want to make this a legit offset smoker, and this is how I do it. The solution? A few extra tools to cut those splits down to size. You'll need a chainsaw lopper, one kindling splitter, one 3-pound hammer, and of course your PPE or personal protective equipment. Now, I get it. No one really wants to drop $300 on an offset smoker and then spend another $300 just to make it a real offset smoker. But for me anyway, these tools are multi-purpose, and I use them for more than just smoking. And also, if I'm being honest, my kids bought Dinah for me as a Father's Day gift a few years ago, and I wasn't about to return it, and not just because it's 105 pounds. But I also wanted a legit offset smoker, not a charcoal smoker, so I was determined to make it work. And as it turns out, I have grown to love it. Do you need to use these exact same tools? Of course not. Any safe way you have at your disposal to cut 12-inch splits in half and then possibly split those in half again will work just fine. Now that we have cut the wood down to size, let's see how it fits in the fire basket. As you can see, this half split is at least 6 times the size of one chunk, and this quarter is about 3 times the size. This is the perfect size fuel you will need to be the pitmaster of your backyard. Hey, we're back. And it's time to get the fire started. Fill a charcoal chimney about 3/4 of the way up. Yes, you will need some charcoal, but it's only the one time to lay a foundation of heat to build your wood fire. If you don't want to use a chimney, you can fill the firebox basket about 1/3 full and light that. But I find that it takes longer to get the coals where you need them. Whatever you do, do not use match light or pre-soaked charcoal. It will ruin the firebox. Now it's time to add the wood to the charcoal base. Start with a couple of quarter splits or one half split. Leave your firebox door open a bit and your firebox vent open all the way for good airflow. Of course, you will need to monitor your firebox. As your wood burns down, it becomes the base of heat, replacing the charcoal, and then you simply add more wood as needed to maintain temp. And let's talk smoke. White smoke versus blue smoke. This here is a good example of what you don't want. White smoke. And this can typically happen with Dyna when you close the firebox door. There's just not enough airflow. Just like with any offset smoker, you may need to leave the firebox door slightly open, and you will probably need a bellows or simply to blow in the fire every once in a while to keep it going. This is a good example of what you do want. Nice, clean blue smoke, barely noticeable. So your meat tastes like smoke and not like ashes. Alrighty, you've seen how to manage the fire in Dyna. Now let's talk about how to manage the temp. And just like with fire management, there's a problem.
We have another problem.
You see, as your fire burns, the heat rises mostly right next to the vent, on the right. And much cooler smoke and heat rises on the left. And that difference can be over 40 degrees within just a foot and a half. To demonstrate this, I set up 2 probes on a grate near the top. Lit a fire and waited 20 minutes.
20 minutes, Chef.
20 minutes?
As you can see, the probe on the right is 47 degrees hotter than the probe on the left. That's a huge difference if you're smoking a large piece of meat like a brisket. But there is a solution, and it's not rotating the meat every 30 minutes. It's a full-size foil pan, 19.5 by 11.5 inches. I buy them at Costco, but you can also get them at a dollar store. Wherever you get one, it needs to be big enough to almost cover the whole lower grate. To demonstrate this, I'm simply going to add the pan on the lowest rack of the smoker. That puts it just above the firebox vent. And then I'm going to add about 4 cups of water to the pan. This blocks the heat from going directly up the right side and distributes it more evenly. And the water helps to regulate the temperature. Now we wait another 20 minutes.
20 minutes.
And as you can see, the temps have evened up nicely. To maintain temp in the smoke zone, I use the side vent and the firebox door to adjust airflow, usually leaving the door open about 2 inches. But be careful. Just like with any open grill or fire, you will need to keep your eye on it. And I think we're done.
That's all, folks.
Well, actually, we're almost done. There is always cleanup.
We do have to do cleanup after?
Yes, we do. But cleaning Dyna is a snap because everything pulls out. Just dump your now cool ashes and wood into the trash and sweep out the rest. And if you use a water pan, you'll save yourself a lot of grief over grease. I usually have very little to clean out or wipe down. nothing a few paper towels couldn't handle. While cleaning Donna is easy, cleaning the grates requires a bit more work. Tip number one, remove the grates you don't need. One time I smoked sausage in the top rack and left the other five racks in there. Needless to say, I had to clean all six. Total bummer. Tip number two, choose the right cleaning pad. Do not use steel wool cleaning pads. They clean up the grates real nice and leave little metal hairs all over it. Not good. And so-called magic erasers or sponges are magic because they disappear piece by piece as you clean the grate. Total waste of money. Brushes are just okay, but it takes longer to clean the grates because it's difficult to get enough contact with the surface area. Heavy-duty scour pads are pretty good. You can fold them over and wrap them around the grate and really get in there. My personal favorite is copper-coated or stainless scour pads. They hold up really well to wear and tear, and I can usually clean all six grates with just one pad. And that, my fellow pitmasters, is how you clean your grates. Tip number three, wipe Dinah down when you're done with seasoning. Just like with a cast iron pan, you don't want to leave excess oils on the steel. It can grow moldy and attract dust and dirt. Tip number four, put that cover on when done. Because of the weird shape of the cover, I put a tie wrap on the cover handle on the firebox side, so I know which way to put it. Yeah, I was always doing it backwards. Final tip, tip number five. Dinah works hard for you, and with just a little effort, you can keep her ship-shape for many a smoke.
Are we done?
Yes. Yes, we are.
Well, that about wraps it all up. The sun is setting, and Dinah's had a long, hard day. It's time to put her to bed with her favorite teddy and bedtime story. I think I've covered just about everything I know about old Dinah here. I hope you found the video informative and entertaining. At least parts of it, anyway. If you're thinking about getting a Dinah wide body, or if you already own one, I hope this helped you out. If you have any further questions or want to see something else, don't hesitate to give me a shout in the comments and I'll get back to you just as soon as I can. And of course, like and subscribe if you're so inclined. Well, partner, I'll see you on down the dusty trail. Next time on the Chuck Wagon.